Thank you for joining this presentation. My name is Martijn Starmans. I'm a PhD student at the Erasmus Medical Center in the Netherlands. And today I will discuss a little bit about my work of predicting histopathological growth patterns in colorectal liver metastasis using CT and radiomics. I have no conflicts of interest to disclose. So we are looking at the histopathological growth patterns, or HGPs, of colorectal liver metastasis. And these HGPs are a prognostic factor of how well chemotherapy will work on these patients. So currently, these HGPs can only be determined postoperatively through a resection. However, it will be beneficial if before surgery, we already know whether chemotherapy will help in these patients. Therefore, the goal here is to find a preoperative, non-invasive alternative using radiomics based on CT. Let's first take a look at the data set that we're using. As a proof of concept, we've only included pure HGPs. So 100% desmoplastic growth pattern against 100% replacement growth pattern. We've included patients from our hospital and ended up with 93 lesions with a 50-50 split between these growth patterns. For all these patients, we have a portal venous phase contrast enhanced preoperative CT. And these scans actually originate from different centers. That's why there's some variation in the acquisition protocols, as you can see in the image on the left. For all these lesions, the HGP was determined by using pathology. In our dataset, each lesion was segmented by three different clinicians. So in our experiments, what we will do, we will use a 100 times random split cross-validation to make sure the model is trained and tested on a different set of patients. And we have two approaches in there. First, we're going to, in the A models, train and test on the same observer. So both in the training set and the test set, we will use segmentations of one observer. In the other experiments, we will use in the training set on the training patients the segmentations from two observers, and on the patients in the test set, the segmentation from the third unseen observer, to see how well the model performs when letting a different radiologist segment the tumor. So let's take a look at the radiomics method we're using. So starting with the images and these segmentations, we're first going to extract features from these images. So these features give us information about these tumors. So for example, we can look at simple descriptors, such as the intensity, for example, the mean intensity of a tumor, or shape, whether it's, for example, more lobular or not, but also more complicated features, like texture features, such as the heterogeneity of a tumor. We do this for all the patients, and then we end up with features for each patient, and for each patient, we already know the growth pattern. So then we can use machine learning and some pre-processing methods to create a decision model. So there's a wide variety of machine learning and pre-processing methods out there, and we don't know beforehand which method will be most suitable for our application. Therefore, we use this platform in which we've collected a whole variety, a wide variety of methods and pre-processing, and we use automatic algorithm optimization to determine the most optimal combination of parameters and methods, which will give us the best decision model. So let's take a look at the results. As stated earlier, we have three observers which did the segmentations, a medicine student, a PhD student, and a radiologist. In the A models, you can see the performance of the single observer models, where both in the patients in the training set and the patients in the test set, we use segmentations from one observer. You can see from the curves and the AUC that there's some relation between these CT imaging features and the growth pattern. In the B models, we have used in the training set for those patients, segmentations from two observers, and for the patient in the test data set, segmentations from a third unseen observer. And you can see that the model benefits from using more segmentations from different observers and still performs well, actually better on the segmentations of a third unseen observer. So what can we conclude from these results? So we saw that radiomics can to some degree predict these pure HGPs on CT. And we also saw that there's a good generalization to segmentations from an unseen observer. So what could such a model be potentially used for? So now we can use this model as a preoperative prognostic marker. So instead of having to do a resection, you could preoperatively already determine what the HGP would be. And what you could also use it for example is in clinical trials to select patients with only a certain histopathological growth pattern. Our study has several limitations. So first of all, the performance is limited. I would say it's not currently suitable for clinical practice yet. Second, we have a small data set. We only had 93 lesions of 76 patients, which might be one of the reasons why the performance is not that good yet. Third, we only looked at pure HGPs as a proof of concept. There are also mixed HGPs, so it would be interesting to see how radiomics those. And lastly, we currently rely on manual annotations, which is not suitable for clinical practice as well, but with automatic methods such as deep learning, this might be solved. Here's my ethics and funding information. And last but not least, this platform that we use to automatically determine the best radiomics decision model is open source, so you can use it as well. It's pretty easy to use because it automatically determines this optimal method. And if you look at ECR this year and previous year, we show that it's actually quite a generic solution as it works in a wide variety of applications. So if you want to try it, visit this link, feel free to contact me. Thank you for joining this presentation. If you have any questions or would like to collaborate on this topic, feel free to send me an email.